initiating brainwave migration between the transplant and the host. Mnemonic activity coming from the transplant. It's degenerated, but it's there. We're going to load you into the strongest memories we can find. They might not be stable. Just hold on.
All Piper ever does, just hangs out and watches what's going on.
Ah, good. The simulation appears to be working, although the memories are quite fragmentary. I'll try to step you through the intact memories and hope we find one that gives us some clue to the Institute's location.
I guess we're going this way.
There. This is the earliest intact memory I can find.
This is like that part of, anyone ever play the original Max Payne? This reminds me of the nightmare sequences.
You are experiencing these memories as Kellogg. This may prove disorienting at first.
I was such a dummy back then. What did I know about how the world worked? I think now she wanted me to kill him. I should have. Instead, I ended up running away. I told myself I wanted to find somewhere out from under the thumb of the NCR and all their rules. But really, I was running from the guilt of not protecting her from Dad. Yeah, it doesn't matter now, though. Mom knew how it was. She wasn't soft, but, she loved me, in her way. And she protected me from Dad. That cost her more than a few beatings. I never knew what happened to her after I left. I didn't want to know. Not then. People always hoping for something better. They usually end up with something worse.
This is what my inner monologue sounds like, by the way.
Dad was either drunk or not around. I guess he must have run with one of the raider gangs, but I never really knew what he did. Don't know why Mom was with him. Maybe at some point in his life he wasn't a complete asshole.
What a joke.
What's it mean, Mom?
Nothing, Connie. People like to talk and hope someone else is going to keep them safe.
Teacher at school said the NCR would bring back the good old days, like before the big war.
Don't you listen to that twaddle. I'm going to stop sending you if that's what they're teaching you.
So he managed to cross the entire country.
Where the fuck did you put my boots?
Listen to me, Connie. You take this. You're old enough. You're the man of the family now. It's your job to protect us. Your father's useless. But you won't turn out like him. You're a good boy. And all that on the radio. All useless talk. The only thing that will protect you in this world is that gun in your hands. You need to learn to use it if you're going to survive.
I will, Mom. I promise. I won't let you down.
You've always been my good boy.
This doesn't seem to be what we're looking for.
Nope.
There appears to be another intact memory close to you in temporal sequence. There. Try that one.
Where? Oh.
The thing about happiness is you only know you had it when it's gone.
Don't it always seem to know?
I mean, you may
don't know
to
what
yourself,
got
that you're
to
happy,
it gone.
But, you don't really believe it. Focus on the petty bullshit or next job or whatever. It's only looking back, by comparison with what comes after, that you really understand that's what happiness felt like.
This is a lot of.
You'll see.
Like,
we don't know anybody here.
Humanizing backstory on a guy
Come on,
that
Sarah, you've got to give it a chance.
Is dead.
I finally got steady work with a good outfit. Nothing like that in the NCR these days.
No, I'm not saying this was a mistake. I'm just... Are you sure these guys know what they're doing? They seem kind of green.
I was the worst thing that ever happened to her. If she'd never met me, she'd have stayed in the hub, maybe hooked up with someone who didn't kill people for a living. Probably been happier than she was with me. Almost certainly lived longer. I know.
Yep, that was Counting Crows.
Whatever made me think that a guy like me should have a daughter? No, I never deserved her. Not for one second.
Just wait. In a few years, I'll be running my own crew. As soon as I make the connections I need. Then I can give you anything you want. And little Mary, too.
I never worried about you before. Must be my mama instincts kicking in. Who knew I had those, huh?
Come on, you're great with her. And you don't need to worry about me. Most of it's just running security for the Shi. A lot of standing around looking tough.
Well, they sure picked the right person for that job.
Listen.
Oh, he was in
it's gonna be great.
San Francisco. Surprised the bridge survived.
This is what's going to keep you and Mary safe. I promise.
Hey, I have that now.
I thought San Francisco was my chance to start fresh. I was the hot shit, the gunslinger from the hub, rolling into town with the world at my feet. Everybody knew I was the one who'd shot Valdez. I could ride
take that, Valdez.
Any outfit in town. It all worked out pretty damn well. For a while.
I know, Connie. I'm sure we're gonna be really happy here.
We are. You'll see. That's okay. I got her.
Let's keep looking. I'll connect you to the next intact memory.
Doop 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 doop.
How did you think this was gonna end, Kellogg? You thought you could just fuck with us, and we wouldn't fuck with you?
So then push me along.
Just so you know, they died like dogs. And you weren't there to help them.
I found another memory to try. I'll connect you.
Oh, there we go.
Mind if we sit down?
Suit yourself. There's always someone who wanted someone else dead. Sometimes just roughed up, but, dead was usually what they wanted. Sometimes they thought they could cheat me. That was usually only when I first arrived somewhere. Didn't matter to me. They just took it as part of the job. Little extra thrown in for free. I always got paid in the end. One way or another.
Okay. That looks like it's probably one memory.
There was always a job for someone like me.
Maybe not.
Didn't matter what it was. Didn't matter who I was supposed to kill. I got pretty good at it.
Okay.
I don't remember much from that time. It all kind of blends together. It was almost always a bar, though. That's universal.
So, I hear you'll take care of people's problems. Is that right?
If you pay me.
Oh, we'll pay you. And,
I didn't care where I was going. Ended up mostly wandering east. Getting as far away from San Francisco as I could, maybe.
See you, Fords. Thanks for stopping by.
That's right.
We pay you when the job's done. Is that okay?
That's the way you want to do it. So who do you want dead?
Well, it's like this. There's his family. Lives down the creek a ways.
Well, we seem to be getting closer. Try this next one.
Where's Valentine? Shouldn't he be in here?
Mr. Kellogg, I'm glad you decided to meet with me.
The first synths weren't all that impressive. I'm good, but I'm not that good. But the Institute could always make more, and kept making them better each time. They still give me the creeps, but you have to get used to them if you want to work with the Institute.
They're not done putting them in yet.
So, you're with the
First synths weren't all that impressive. Mm-hmm. I'm good.
Didn't know that was going to repeat.
Not that good. I finally ended up in the Commonwealth. I kind of ran out of road. Plus, I'd come to terms with life. I wasn't going to be stupid enough to get mixed up with caring about other people again. It was just me against the world. And the world had it coming.
Take that, world.
Institute.
You heard all sorts of rumors about the Institute. But I figured they were just a convenient boogeyman for anything bad that ever happened. They were real, all right. They didn't know anything about operating on the surface. Relied on their synths for everything.
Time.
They had the resources.
Take it from one another bald man.
And I had the expertise.
Time is how you lose all that hair.
Turned into a permanent arrangement. Suited me just fine.
I wanted to see for myself if you really existed.
We do, as you can see.
What do you want?
It's come to my attention that you've been rather disruptive of our operations lately. This must stop.
I do what people pay me to do. If that's a problem for you, I could see only one way out.
And what's that, Mr. Kellogg?
If I'm working for you, there's no more problem. From what I hear, you can afford me.
I don't think you fully understand the situation you're in.
I think I do.
Very well. B-748. Initiate. Impressive. We may have something to talk about after all.
Getting warmer. One of these has got to tell us something.
I'm not sure that has to.
There's one that looks mostly intact. Connecting now.
Manual override initiated. Cryogenic state.
How's now the Institute's main operator in the Commonwealth? If they needed something done, they came to me. It wasn't usual for anybody from the Institute to come along on a mission, so this one stood out. I didn't know then who it was we were grabbing from the vault. Of course. Neither did they. Not really. The eggheads never liked taking orders from a dirty, contaminated degenerate.
Always
like
liked
me.
Beer. Liked couches even
they
more.
They needed me. And I made sure they knew it. The eggheads never liked taking orders from a dirty, contaminated degenerate like me. But they needed me, and I made sure they knew it. I never knew why we didn't just refreeze the rest of them. But we had our orders. Guess the old man didn't want so many loose ends. Too bad he left alive the one person he shouldn't have.
All computers are...
I'm glad I didn't have to kill the kid. I'm not saying I haven't done it, but, I never liked to. But it was better this way. Better than taking his kid and leaving him alive.
Hey, that's us.
Still working.
Even then, I knew it was a mistake leaving her alive. I understood that kind of revenge. No one better. But I was cocky enough to assume I could handle some soft, pre-war vault dweller. Even if she somehow got thawed out. At least I know those Institute bastards will soon get what's coming to them, too. If she could take me out, they won't be able to hide from her for long.
That's right. I was a lawyer.
That's good. Checking through the logs. Hopefully it's all...
Just find it.
Pod C6, down the hall near the end.
I owe you one husband.
This is the one. Here.
I don't know, maybe, Joe. Definitely kind of sounds like it, doesn't it? Hi, me.
Is it over? Almost. Everything's going to be fine.
Come here, baby.
No. I've got him.
You should have just pretended they were vault people.
I'm only going to tell you once.
I'm not giving you Sean!
God damn it. Get the kid out of here and let's go. At least we still have a backup.
Bye, me.
Biogenic sequence reinitialized.
What's the holdup?
I'm almost finished, Kellogg. I just need to confirm... All right, we're good.
I'm sorry you had to go through that again. I found another intact memory. Whenever you're ready.
Hey, I think we're gonna see Sean. Apparently, there's the exit. There he is.
Is that your son? This appears to be a very recent memory. So, good news, I think.
Wasn't my idea to settle down with the kid in the middle of Diamond City. I thought it was a terrible idea, actually. But it was one of the old man's pet projects, so here we were. Me and the kid. Like a happy little family. I ended up kind of liking it. A reminder of what my life might have been if things had turned out differently. But there's no going back. I knew it was just temporary. It'd be back to normal business before too long.
I think this one on the end might be a comic book.
His whole setup in Diamond City was part of some elaborate plan of the old man's. Seems obvious now that we were bait for our friend from the vault. Timing couldn't have been an accident. It's not how the old man works. I wonder if he outsmarted me in the end. Another loose end tied up.
Kellogg.
The new breed of synths could easily pass as human. Some of them did. But the coursers, they weren't built to blend in. They were killing machines, pure and simple. Smarter, stronger, and faster than almost any real human. I'm just glad they were always on my side.
Oh. Game just crashed. Hang on a second. That would just went from being around to not being around in one fell swoop. Hopefully we don't have to go through too much of that.
Hello?
Wait, where am I now? Holy crap, did it back me up all the way to back to here?
Well, well.
Oh, this will be fun.
Mr. Valentine, I thought you had forgotten about little old me.
May have walked out of the den, Irma.
Well, we gotta work our way through this again.
On you.
Amari's downstairs, you big flirt.
Synth Corsair terminated the game. Alright, Nick, let's go. Alright, this is gonna take a bit. Oh, that was not what I meant to do. Try to blaze through this as fast as I can.
Dr. Amari?
Yes, I take it this isn't a social call.
We need your help.
I know it, Jack.
Are you two putting aside the fact?
Please.
This debt.
Fine. Here's what I could find.
What's this? This isn't a brain.
Uh-huh.
That's the hippocampus. And this thing attached to it?
Those circuits look awfully familiar.
Yeah.
Surprise. From what I've seen.
Ryan was handing out some subs earlier.
Go on, Dr.
Mr. Valentine. But that's.
Mm-hmm. Don't worry about me.
Hey. I appreciate
you. You can thank me.
Whenever you're ready, Mr. Valentine.
Whoop.
Just sit down.
If I start cackling like an old grizzled mercenary, pull me out, okay?
Let's see here.
Can I skip ahead here?
I need you to keep talking to me, Mr. Valentine. Any slight change in your cognitive functions could be dire. Are you feeling any different?
There's a lot of flashes. Static. I can't make sense of any of it, John.
Well, don't mind me while you guys are doing that. I'm just going to rob you blind.
The mnemonic.
Hell yeah.
Includes a holotape?
Impressions are encoded. It appears the Institute has one last. There's a lock on the memories in the implant.
Tell me you.
Let me think. We load both.
Did I steal something?
Oh, well. As a host.
All right.
Just sit down over there.
See you on the other side.
That's what you do when you go to the doctors, you steal everything.
Initiating brainwave migration between the transplant and the host. Mnemonic activity coming from the transplant. It's degenerated, but it's there. We're going to load you into the strongest memories we can find. They might not be stable. Just hold on.
Ba-dum-bum. All right. Well, if you lick them all, they don't want them back, so then you get as many as you want.
Can you hear me? Ah, good. The simulation appears to be working, although the memories are quite fragmentary.
Thanks for the 500 bits, Ryan.
Contact memories and hope we find one that gives us some clue to the Institute's location.
All right, let's go.
There. This is the earliest intact memory I can find.
Wonder if I can move through these things faster, or if I have to sit and watch the whole thing. Like, if I just go like this, it seems
this
like
it doesn't seem to be what we're looking for.
All right. As you can imagine, we'll be doing
there
a bunch of quick saving.
To be another intact memory close to you in temporal sequence. There. Let's keep looking. I'll connect you to the next intact memory.
Hey, thanks for the 20 bits, Tinky.
How did you think this was going to end, Kellogg?
I found another memory.
You thought you could just fuck with us, and we wouldn't fuck with you?
At least they let you just run through it if you don't want to watch it. It's this nice thing. I was afraid they was gonna make me sit through all of this stuff again.
Getting closer. Try this next one.
Turned it into a speed run. Yeah, if it was a speed run, though, there's probably some way to jump out of one of these off this thing and crash land into the memory at the end.
Ah, there's one that looks mostly intact. Connecting now.
Cryogenic stasis suspended.
I found another intact memory. Whenever you're ready.
All right, and we're back.
Is that your son? This appears to be a very recent memory. So, good news, I think.
Piper's really done it this time. I mean, I'm not saying she's right, but... Mayor,
Come on, Courser. Where are you? There you are.
Kellogg.
It's okay. One of these days, you're gonna get your head blown off just barging in here like that.
Minimizing my exposure to civilians is a priority.
Forget I said anything. So what's the big crisis this time?
New orders for you. One of our scientists has left the Institute.
Left? As in?
He's gone rogue. Name's Dr. Brian Virgil. We know he's hiding somewhere in the glowing sea. Here's his file.
Glowing sea.
Wow. Some heads are gonna roll for this. Capture and return, or just elimination?
Elimination. He was working on a highly classified program.
No kidding. One of the top bioscience boys? Damn. So...
I want to see the paper.
I guess you're taking the kid back with you.
Oh, it's blank.
Affirmative. Your only mission is to locate and eliminate Virgil.
You're taking me home to my father?
Yes. Stand next to me and hold still.
Okay.
I thought future paper didn't have corners. That's actually extremely fat past paper. Oops, spoilers.
X688, ready to relay with Sean.
Bye, Mr. Kellogg. I hope I see you again soon.
We have teleporters?
Teleportation. Now it all makes sense. Nobody's found the entrance to the Institute because there is no entrance. Let me pull you out of there as soon as you're ready.
Yay, it didn't crash this time.
Slow movements, okay? I don't know what kind of side effects the procedure might have had. No one's ever done this before.
Where's Valentine?
How do you feel?
I'm okay, Doctor. Thank you.
That's good. But I want you to keep monitoring yourself. We have to be sure there's no long-term damage. Are you ready to talk about what happened in there?
You were along for the ride, weren't you? You saw what I saw.
Yes, but it's important we review everything together, in case either of us missed anything.
There's more than one person who knows about the Institute. Virgil. That scientist who escaped.
I didn't know Institute scientists could defect. This changes everything. He could answer all sorts of questions. Where did the memory say he was? The glowing sea? That can't be right. No one would risk going there. Not even to hide.
Why? What makes the glowing sea so dangerous?
Probably the glowing,
says it all.
I'm guessing.
Radiation. So much that nothing there could possibly live. Nothing pleasant. Navigating radioactive hazards is nothing new, but the glowing sea can kill a man in seconds. That's why it doesn't make sense. Virgil fleeing into that hell. The exposure alone.
That's why he's there. To make the Institute think twice about following him.
That must be it. He's using the radiation in the glowing sea like a shield or a cloak, a way to throw them off and be at an advantage. If Virgil found a way to survive there, you'll have to do the same.
Turn into
if
a ghoul.
Going to follow him.
How do I fight that much radiation, Doctor?
There are chemical compounds. Rad-X, Rad-Away. You'd need as much as you could carry. Maybe more. A sealed environment suit would be great, if you could find one. Or maybe one of those suits of power armor? That would be perfect.
I'll find a way to get through the rads. Don't worry.
Good luck. And be safe. By the way, I unplugged Mr. Valentine first. Removed the implant while you were waking up. He's waiting for you upstairs.
I was wondering if they were going to deal with that or if it was just going to be a dangling plot hole. Bone cutter. Anything else I want to steal from here?
Seen better days, hasn't it?
All right, let's go talk to Nick. Where are you, Nick? Nicholas. There you are.
Hey, Valentine.
Hope you got what you were looking for inside my head. That was right. I should have killed you when you were on ice.
Kellogg, is that you?
What? What are you talking about?
You sounded like Kellogg just then.
Did I? Huh. Mari said there might be some mnemonic impressions left over. Anyway, I feel fine, so let's get going. Or I could head back to Diamond City, since you've got company already.
I'll see you around, Nick.
Good luck out there. You know where to find me.
We should head over to the Nakano residence when we can. Find out what their case is about.
Alright, let's go around here a little bit. So we did not have an opportunity to before.
The memory den's not accepting new clients right now, sweetheart.
Irma.
Oh, enjoying yourself in Good Neighbor? It's a heck of a town, ain't it?
Textbook. I thought that was an overdue library book for a second. Alright. Well, let's check out whatever is upstairs and then leave it. Oh, I just crashed again. Well, this isn't going particularly well right now. Let me check on this. I think this is trying to tell me that I should just go ahead and... Oop, that's me. That's not what I was trying for. And that's also the wrong thing. Man, I'm getting the wrong stuff all over here. There we go. Alright, where's the continue here? Oh, do I have to go through this whole bit again? Alright, we're gonna get back to where we were and then I'll probably close up the stream for the day. Or we could close it up now and I could just do this off camera, I guess. It's a little bit earlier.
It's okay. But one of these days.
Probably for the best we just show close up for now, because apparently Fallout is being
So what's the big
wonky at the moment. Probably need to restart my computer or something to make it be a little bit better. So, has left the Institute. So thanks for joining me, everybody, and I'll see you guys in the next stream, which should be Wednesday for another RimWorld stream. Thanks, everybody.
Wow. Some heads are gonna roll for this.